This is a computer including Wi-Fi, and I was super excited to find out that you can run LUA scripts on it. Let's go to the workbench. I'll show you how to do it.
First of all, of course, you'll need the ESP8266 module, in this case the ESP1. You'll need a breadboard and a 3.3 volt power supply. I have the 3.3 volt on the upper rail. This is a USB to serial adapter with 3.3 volt levels, and of course you need a bunch of jumper wires. Here's a quick overview of the pinout of the module. So I'll show you how to connect all the wires from the bottom side. All the drawings are always from the top side. I'll show you how to do it from the bottom side. And we'll start with the ground wire. I always take a black one for that, and it goes into the upper left corner. Next up, there's a positive wire in the lower right corner. I'll take a red one for that. Then I go for the receive and transmit pair. I'll take a gray wire in the upper right corner and a white wire in the lower left. I left those two joined. Next one, there's this CHPD wire that always needs to go to the positive 3.3 volt rail. And this GPIO 0, which we leave floating unless we need to upgrade the firmware. So I'll plug my serial to USB converter into the breadboard, connect positive wire and CHPD wire to the positive rail, the ground rail, and next thing you must never forget is to join the common ground of your module with your USB to serial converter, otherwise you won't have a common ground reference. And the transmit and receive pair. Keep in mind that one end's transmit pin is the other end's receive pin, so you have to connect the TXD to RXD and vice versa. Yep, power light comes on. Looking good. Right, now on my computer this module comes up as COM4. Yep, here we go. That's the firmware I flashed to the system in my previous video. To go into firmware upgrade mode, we have to pull GPIO 0 to ground and need the to flash LUA on it. Of course, we need the nodeMCU firmware, which we download from GitHub. I went for the latest release that was available. I suppose that there'll be a newer one now. Yep, that's right. We'll just download that. And using the MCU flasher software, we can upload that to our module. And just like in the previous video, it won't work right away. Again, you'll have to power cycle the module once or twice so it goes into firmware upgrade mode. I'll do that right now and click download again, and there we go. I had to speed that up a little. It takes about a minute or two. The module never leaves update mode. I'll just power cycle that again. And of course disconnect GPIO 0 so it will leave update mode. So what do we have now? Well, looks like LUA can't open init.lua. That would be the the code that starts up automatically. To see that it does do anything at all, I simply connect a passive infrared sensor. This thing runs on 5 volts. I have the 5 volts on the lower rail here on my breadboard. And before you start yelling at me, Andy, you can't do that, you'll fry your inputs. No, it really runs on 3.3 volts, and actually you could short out the voltage regulator and it would run on 3.3 volts natively. So it won't blow the inputs because the output of the sensor really is 3.3 volts. And I can read those the GPIO status from a terminal program. You'll see that in a second. Here, just type print GPIO read 3 and it'll give the pin status, and if I activate the alarm I get a 1 here. Okay, cool. So this thing obviously works, and in the next part of my tutorial, you might have guessed where it's going to, I'll show you how to make a simple web-enabled burglar alarm with a LUA script and just very few lines of PHP code on a Raspberry Pi or any other LAMP server for that matter.